Now, around this time that Anne and I were entering the world, something else was being born in the Holland family. But it wasn't a person. It was the first of many businesses that my dad, with my mom's support, would bring into the world.
Sally Industries, a robot factory.
That's right. Dad started Sally in the garage of our house over 30 years ago with a couple of friends, including John Wood, the company's current CEO. In the old days, Dad and John and their quickly growing team would cut apart mannequins, install electric motors, and then scrummage through their wives' makeup drawers, hoping to convert these figures into talking salespeople. The grand idea was for all the department stores to trade up from stationary mannequins to talking ones. I recall one story where at a trade show in New York, one of these scary-looking mannequins actually went awry and accidentally started groping an innocent bystander. Well, after let's just call it sluggish sales of these talking mannequins, Sally turned to selling the Clobot. Yes, the part clone, part robot. I think this tagline says it all. Through our unique direct facial molding process, Sally Unlimited Ink can duplicate any person, live or wax figure, for only $5,000. Or, if you're a dentist, you might be interested in the company's four-armed ultimate assistant? But, despite its humble beginnings, over the years, Sally has become a nationally recognized animatronics firm. And today, its robotic characters can be found in some of the biggest and best theme parks around the world. So the Sally story is one with a really terrific ending. But once again, in the spirit of the stories behind the stories, we also wanted to share with you some of the more obscure Sally-inspired endeavors, like the submarine. Yes, Dad thought that he was going to transform the world of personal water transportation. After all, who needs a boat to travel above the water when you can own and drive your own submarine? A pretty impressive series of prototypes were built. Here's a shot of me and Mom testing out the luxurious interior of one. And Dad, never shy to be on camera, produced a sales video that was definitely ahead of its time. But thankfully, Dad returned to his robotic roots before betting the farm on this waterlogged idea. And then there was the living nightmare. This was a walk-through, Disney-like haunted house built at the now-defunct Phillips Highway Mall. And for literally every day for weeks leading up to its Halloween opening, the whole family commuted to the mall to help build this spectacle. I think my parents even took me out of school for a couple days when they were getting worried about it opening on time. Yes, but while I guess this was a nightmare in more ways than just its name, it really was a lot of fun.